Hello my dear friends and welcome to StudyIQ. I'm Joycey Joy and today in this lecture we will discuss about foreign terrorist organizations or FTOs. Now if you look at the current affairs, the US Secretary of State recently announced the US intent to designate the Islamic Revolutionary Guard Corps, that is IRGC, including its Quds force, as a FTO or as a foreign terrorist organization. So in this context, we will understand what is foreign terrorist organization. From your UPSC perspective, this is a very important topic for your GS paper 2, and this comes under bilateral or international relations. So we will discuss about foreign terrorist organizations in detail in this lecture, and we will also understand why did the United States designate IRGC or the Quds force as a FTO. What are the implications of it? We will discuss all these in detail in this lecture. But before we begin, this is our channel StudyIQ, and we are providing pen drive courses for various competitive examinations, including SSC and bank courses, UPSC optionals, SSC JE courses, teaching examination, railway examination, defense examination, RBI grade B, NABARD grade A, UGC NET, UPSC Civil Services Examination, CLAT examinations, state PSCs, and also for various professional courses. You can visit our website www.studyiq.com for more details, or you can call to any of these numbers for more information. Let us first understand what is IRGC and Quds Force and why they were designated as FTO or foreign terrorist organization by the United States. So first, IRGC was set up in 1979, and it was set up as an ideologically driven branch of the armed forces of Iran. And the aim of setting up IRGC was to protect the newly established Islam system from hostile foreign powers and internal dissensions. So it was an ideology based armed forces of Iran, and the aim was to protect the Islamic system from hostile foreign powers in Iran. And IRGC's present status is that it has 125,000 members. So it is a very strong force, and it has ground wing, naval wing, and air wings. So it's a very strong force now. And it is tasked with internal and border security, law enforcement, and protection of Iran's missiles. So these are the functions of IRGC today. And it also controls the Basij Militia, a semi-government paramilitary force estimated to have up to 1 million active members. Now, Quds or the Quds Force is an elite wing of the IRGC. So, Quds Force is also a part of IRGC. It's a elite wing of IRGC, and they report directly to the Supreme Leader. And Quds Force have around 10,000 to 20,000 members, and it carries out unconventional warfare beyond the Iran's borders. So this is briefly about IRGC and Quds Force. Now we will understand what is an FTO or what is a foreign terrorist organization. So Section 219 of the United States Immigration and Nationality Act provides for the designation of an organization as an FTO, and it authorizes the Secretary of the State to designate an organization as an FTO. So Secretary of State of United Nations has recently announced its intent to designate IRGC and Quds Force as an FTO. So according to Section 219 of the United States Immigration and Nationality Act, it is the function or duty of the Secretary of State in order to designate an organization as an FTO. And the Secretary of State can do so if he or she feels or finds that the organization is a foreign organization. So these are the conditions. So it should be a foreign organization. Secondly, the organization should engage in terrorist activity or terrorism. And thirdly, the organization threatens the security of the US nationals or the national security of the country. So if these three conditions are met, the Secretary of the State can designate an organization as an FTO. And FTO designation plays a very critical role in the United States fight against terrorism. and it is an effective means of curtailing support for terrorist activities and pressure groups. And at present, currently, 67 terrorist organizations are on the list of FTOs of United States. These include Hamas, Hezbollah, Al-Qaeda, the regional branches of Al-Qaeda, Islamic State, IS, Boko Haram, etc. And in the list of 67 FTOs, there are many terrorist organizations which are based in Pakistan and Afghanistan and which provide a direct threat to India. So, in that way, it is very significant for India also. For example, Jaish-e-Mohammed, Lashkar-e-Taiba, Lashkar-e-Janvi. So, all these terrorist organizations which are based in Afghanistan and Pakistan and poses direct threat to India are also in the list of 67 FTOs by United States. So, this provides a significance for India here. And in case of India, the Indian Mujahideen, LTTE, Harkat-ul-Jihad, etc. are also on the list of 67. Now, let us understand why is IRGC designated as an FTO by the United States. First reason, IRGC, it's a part of Iran's official military. So, it is a part of the government or part of Iran's official military. They have engaged in terrorist activity for the past 40 years or since its inception. And its support for terrorism is foundational and institutional. That means it is a part of the government and it is institutional. And it has killed many US citizens. So the second condition, the organization should be a terrorist organization. And the third condition, the US citizens or the national security of the US should be affected. So these two conditions are met. And the first condition, obviously, it's a foreign organization. Therefore, all the three conditions are met. And therefore, the US has intended to designate IRGC as a FTO. And now coming to the details of it. The Iranian regime is responsible for the death of at least 603 American service members in Iraq since 2003. And this accounts for 17% of the deaths of US personnel in Iraq from 2003 to 11. So within a period of 7 years, this organization is responsible for the death of 17% of US personnel in Iraq. And IRGC is also responsible for taking hostages and wrongfully detaining numerous US persons. And many of the US persons are still in captivity in Iran today. And also through the Quds force, IRGC is conducting and carrying out global terrorist campaign. For example, in Germany, Bosnia, Bulgaria, Kenya, Bahrain, Turkey, etc. Now, what is the contention here? The designation of IRGC as an FTO highlights that Iran is an outlaw regime that uses terrorism as a key tool of statecraft, because IRGS is a part of the state or a part of the government. It's an institutional mechanism. So this makes it fundamentally different from any other government. And this is for the first time that the United States has designated a part of another government as an FTO. There are already 67 organizations on the list, but none of them are a part of the government. They are individual or independent terrorist organizations. So this is for the first time that a part of the government has become a part of the FTO list of the United States. And that's why this is very important. You can expect a question in the UPSC preliminary examination. This is because in case of India also it is significant, and also this is for the first time that a part of the government is being declared as a FTO by the United States. So declaring or designating a foreign military as an FTO may put the US troops, particularly in the neighboring Iraq, at risk. So this is the implication or this is the risk for US. So if IRGS is declared as an FTO, the US troops in the neighboring Iraq would be at risk. Now let us understand what is Iran's stance on this. Iranian President Hassan Rouhani has condemned the US as the leader of world terrorism. So he is putting back the allegation on US. He said that America has used terrorists as a tool in the region while the guards have fought against them from Iraq to Syria. So, Iran's stance is that the guards or the IRGC They have tried to protect the people of their country. And in a retaliatory action, the Iran named United States Central Command, that is CENTCOM, as a terrorist organization, and US government is the sponsor of the terror group CENTCOM. Now let us understand what are the possible implications of it. So if US designates IRGC as an FTO, this will have sweeping economic and travel sanctions on IRGC, on any organization or a company or an individual who have links to IRGC. So globally, the business organizations or the banks will have to ensure that the companies with which they have financial transactions are not connected to IRGC in any way. And also with the present designation of IRGC as an FTO, Iran has threatened US that they will resume its suspended nuclear work. And the IRGC commanders have warned the US bases in Middle East and the US aircraft carriers in the Gulf about an attack. And Iran has also threatened to disrupt the oil shipments. So we can say that there will be rising tensions in the Middle East, and this will have an implication on India as well, because the oil prices can go up, which will have an impact on Indian economy. Again, there can be security threats, because if Iran resumes its nuclear work, it is a security threat for India, and other implications as well. You can follow my Facebook page for more video updates, and please write to me at joycy.studyiq.com for any of your queries or clarifications. Thank you.